It's a great place for newlyweds like yourselves. And with the old resort being wrecked in the hurricane, and you coming in the off season, it'd be like you rented out the whole place yourself.
It's because we did. We had to call them months in advance.
Well, the wait is over. Come on, I'll show you the place.
Well, here it is. Everything you could ask for. Kitchen, living room, dining area, a couple bedrooms through here.
So you like it all right?
It's beautiful.
Excellent. Well, anything else you need, just call. Oh, one more thing. During this time of the year, it's best not to go in the water. Between the sea turtle migrations, recent shark activity, and strong currents, you don't want to take the risk.
Not go in the water at all? Isn't this a beach resort?
I know it sounds silly, but it's absolutely in your best interest. And with everything there is to do, I'm sure you'll have lots to keep yourself busy with.
Well, we'll keep that in mind. Thanks for everything.
No problem. Congrats again, Mr. and Mrs. Mungo.
All right, thank you.
Bye.
See you later.
Thank you. Okay, is it just me or is this just giving you really weird vibes?
Weird how?
There's literally no one else here. The weird warning not to go into the water. I don't know, I just have a feeling. Okay, tell me you heard that too.
Yeah, that was a little creepy.
Okay, fine. Don't believe me. My first husband didn't either.
Come on.
Thank you. Almost as good as when you said it 10 minutes ago.
Oh, come on. Look at this place. Where else am I going to reflect on such romantic thoughts and feelings?
You're ridiculous. Hey, you got some sun today. You look a little burnt.
You saying I look hot? So I accept your compliment.
That's terrible. It's almost as bad as the line you used to ask me out. What was it?
Oh, yeah?
Are you an angel because you look like you fell from heaven?
Oh, I didn't say that.
Yes, you did. No. I wouldn't forget something like that.
Oh, that's an amateur line.
Okay. What's a line that a pro like yourself would use then?
Good thing I brought my library card.
Oh, no. Because
I'm totally checking
no.
you out.
Oh, you're awful.
Well, here we are. So it worked. You know what? Screw this.
What are you doing?
Take a dip. You wanna come?
No, the caretaker said not to go in the water. I don't want my husband to only have one leg because he got eaten by a shark.
Okay, first of all, that's insensitive to people only one leg and sharks. And this is our honeymoon, alright? I'm gonna make the most of it. You want to know something funny?
What's that?
I had trouble remembering our first date the other night. You know, when we went to see that movie? I mean, I know we saw a movie, but for the life of me, I couldn't remember what it was. You know, what we did before, or what we did right after, even.
Tristan? Babe?
All I know is that they forgot to put butter on your popcorn, and it really pissed you off, which was really cute.
And I'll never be over that.
Well, that's why I make sure your popcorn has enough butter to give us both heart disease. Sleep.
And you woke me up to tell me that?
No, but what if this place really is haunted?
Then I hope the ghosts come smother you with a pillow so I can go back to sleep.
I feel loved.
You are.
Thank you.
better?
Good.
It's been a while since you've had an attack.
What do you mean?
You know, a night terror. I mean, you sleepwalk every once in a while, but I guess the last attack you had was after that fight you had with your parents, and you had to sleep on my couch that night. And that was like...
Tristan, I don't sleepwalk. I never have.
Yeah, you do. I've seen it. It's kind of cute.
No, I don't. And even if I did, I have no idea when you'd have seen it.
Well, you wouldn't remember because you're sound asleep.
But that's not even what happened. I couldn't go back to sleep after you woke me up, and I got up to get a glass of water, and then that stupid alarm clock started going off. And then that's when I heard you down on the beach, except it wasn't you because you disappeared into the water, and then something pulled me under, and... Okay.
And that doesn't sound like a nightmare to you. Alright, one thing at a time. What alarm clock are you talking about? Pretty sure that thing is dead.
No, it was on. Go check.
It's not even plugged in.
Well, it was. Maybe I tripped over the cord when I was running around, or the batteries were broken, or something.
You know what? It's just a prank. That's all it is. Someone being stupid. We're safe, alright? I promise. What I think you should do is finish your tea, get some sleep, and I think you'll feel much better in the morning.
I don't know if I'm gonna be able to sleep.
Let's stay here for a bit.
Okay. You know how when someone has a near-death experience, say their life flashes before their eyes?
Sure.
I saw something when I went under the water. I was in a field, and it was beautiful. And you were there, but...
Probably nothing.
Hi.
Well, hi.
What time is it?
It is beach time. So whatever time you want it to be.
I'm sorry, again, about what happened last night.
Don't even worry about it. If you wanted to go night swimming, all you had to do was say so.
Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be getting in the water again anytime soon.
Well, we've got a big day of doing nothing ahead of us. So.
I can't wait.
Come in. It's nicer than yesterday.
That's not saying much.
All right, come on, just up to your knee at the most.
I don't know. What?
I'm not letting one nightmare ruin your whole honeymoon.
What are you talking about? Tristan Kennedy, you better not drop me.
It's okay. You're safe. It'll be all right.
I want to go back.
No, just look at me. Don't look at the waves.
Really, put me down!
Fine, I'm just trying
Seriously,
to help you.
Seriously, let go!
Okay.
Look, I know you mean well, but last night was traumatizing for me, okay? You can't just act like it didn't happen.
Elle, come back. thought you might need this.
Not a bad idea. Thanks.
Do you need anything else?
No, I don't think so. Tristan?
Yeah.
I'm sorry that I snapped at you earlier. I know you were just trying to help me.
I'm sorry too. I was trying to get into that water and I shouldn't have. I wasn't thinking.
But you're right, I'm not gonna let it ruin the rest of our trip.
So we're good.
Always. Could you do me one more favor before you get settled?
Sure.
Get me a drink?
Yeah, I'll be right back.
Thanks. One bottle of soda.
Well, you know how easily I get sidetracked. Are you going back down to the pool?
Not right now. I have something planned.
What?
It's a surprise. You'll see.
All right.
What are you writing?
Just writing my journal a bit.
I didn't know you had a journal.
Sure you did. You've seen me write in it before.
I have not.
I have too.
Is there anything about me in there?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Well, you should know that dinner's pretty much ready, so you better go wash up.
I guess I'd better. Coming.
Okay, I worked really hard on this. So if it tastes awful, you just have to pretend, okay?
It's not going to be awful.
Well, since you so bravely saved my life last night, I thought the least I could do is make your favorite meal.
So what's this?
Rice and beans. Doesn't it look right? I mean, I know it's my first time eating the recipe, but I thought I did all
right. It looks right, but why this?
Because you ask for this for your birthday every year, and you practically beg me to go with you to that Cuban place at least twice a month.
sorry, are you confusing me with someone else?
Excuse me?
Oh, I've never liked Caribbean food. Ever. It looks great, though. I'll give you that. Solid presentation.
Are you messing with me?
No, I have no idea what you're talking about.
How long have you and I known each other?
Sorry?
How long have you and I known each other?
3 years? Four if you count when we started dating?
You sure about that?
Does it really matter now?
Tristan, we have known each other since high school. That's over 7 years.
Okay, well, you're the one who forgot my favorite food.
No. I specifically remember you saying that this was your favorite. I saved a recipe that your own mother gave me
my
so
mom
that I
has
could
never
make
made
it. Just try the food!
It is nothing. Please.
Last night, Elle had another night terror. I found her in the water on the beach. I don't know what would have happened if I hadn't gotten there in time. It's been so long, I don't know what triggered this. I found a message in a bottle that makes me think. Makes you think what?
It's stupid. Did that clock just turn
on? It's broken, remember? Makes you think what?
Okay, hey, don't change the subject. Did that clock just start counting
Please,
down?
Please, just shut up about it.
Elle, I really don't want to fight.
Then tell me.
How did we get here?
The caretaker drove us.
No.
What do you remember?
Before that, Elle, do you remember him picking us up from the airport? Or us getting off a plane, or us getting on a plane?
No, I don't. Why don't I? Do you?
Mosaic project.
What is that? What do you mean?
I don't know. I don't know what it is. Do you think someone could really be watching us?
I don't know. I mean, we're literally the only people here, and we don't know how we got here, and we don't know how to leave. I've been seeing and hearing things, and then my night terrors start up again all of a sudden, all at the same time. Look, I know it sounds crazy when you say it like that, but what if we were drugged or something? I mean, this could all be some kind of experiment,
okay,
and I just...
You just need to calm down and not make too much into this, okay?
Would you save her, if you could?
Only one of us can get out of this. are they?
Who?
This isn't normal. None of this is normal. Something is happening here, or I'm losing my mind. I don't know where I am. I don't know how I got here. I don't know what's going on. I don't even know who you are.
What are you talking about?
Someone brought me here. Someone or something did something to my memories, and I don't know why. Are you in on it? Have you been messing with me this whole time, just like all these other girls?
No, Elle, what other girls? What happened to you? Elle! Listen, we need to talk about this.
Go ahead. Seems there's a lot you haven't said.
Excuse me?
I read your journal, Tristan. Stop lying.
Believe me, I didn't write that. Okay, that's not me. I don't know about you, but I'm having these memories. Things I've done, places I've been. With no recollection of doing it. It's like deja vu, but in reverse somehow. I do remember one thing. It was a long time ago. I was at my grandparents' house one summer. Must have been 9 or 10. They lived on a farm out in the country. Really nice place. They had all these trails that would snake across the farm, and I'd ride my bike up and down them. One day, I was doing just that, and I came across a fawn. A real small one, huddled there in the grass. I thought it was dead until I biked up to it and looked up at me, right in the eyes. So I went back to the house to get my granddad and took him to where the fawn was laying. I took one look at it, said I know what to do. So I picked it up by its hind legs, tossed it over his shoulder, and it howled in pain. It said it was going to put it out of its misery, that it was beyond saving. Well, little old me was not going to stand for that. So I told him, I said, if you kill that thing, I will never love you again. And I meant it too. He didn't like that too much. So he put it down, looked me right in the eyes, said this thing is not worth saving, boy. He said he'd beat me for talking back. I didn't care. So I got what was coming to me. Anyway, my grandma intervened after about 4 hits. She could hear the screaming from the house. She took to the vet later, and before long, they released the fawn back out into the wild. I know when something's worth fighting for, Elle. We are not beyond saving. And that's the truth. I can hold on to that.
What do you remember?
Nothing. anything. It's all faded, not real.
Nothing at all. What's my favorite color?
Blue?
It's red. What about our wedding day? Oh, baby, please try. What about our first dance? You have to remember that.
I don't know anything. I don't even know you anymore. After that, I can't trust you.
Come on, yes you can. You know me.
Look. Sooner or later, you're going to have to accept that we don't know each other. Not really. Someone brought us here, made us think we were... I want to trust you.
You can.
Then get me out of here. We have to find a way out.
I can't make any promises.
Do you really love me?
Yes, I do.
I'm sorry. This is all way too much at once. I have to get some real rest or I'm gonna pass out.
Alright, that's probably for the best. We'll go to bed. We'll figure this out in the morning.
I think I should sleep on the couch tonight. Alone.
Wait. Take the bed. I don't mind sleeping on the couch. Please.
Nothing's working.
Oh, hey. I made you breakfast.
Thank you. So, you've been hiding secret cooking skills from me, too.
Actually, I didn't know I could cook, to be honest. But nothing makes sense at this point.
Look, I get what you're trying to do here, but there's...
I know it's a lot to take in with everything that's happened. Whether or not you're my wife, and whether or not we know each other, I would never do anything to intentionally hurt you, and I don't want to lose you.
Well, I've always had a way with words. At least that's consistent.
If it's all right with you, I'd like to take a look around. I think we need to do some investigating together.
I don't think that we have another choice.
That's exactly. I want to see just how alone we are here. I mean, there's got to be an end at some point.
Yesterday, after I left the beach, I walked as far as I could go in one direction, and I got to the end, and it was nothing. It just dropped off in jungle for miles, all these trees. But there's got to be a road, right? I mean, we drove here.
There's only one way to find out.
So, The Shining was your first R-rated movie?
Yeah, first R-rated horror movie. But I kept my eyes shut and my ears covered for most of it. So, technically speaking, it was The Matrix.
Oh. Fight Club was mine.
Well, you just broke the first two rules, so...
You know, you're making it really hard to hate you. I just wish...
Well, great. Another dead end. Looks like I'm going around in circles.
We are going around in circles.
Shall we?
I don't think I need to hold your hand.
I just thought
Let's just figure the rest of this out first, okay? What is that?
Alright, we might want to go. I've seen that black fog before. Nothing good follows.
No. We've come this far. There's something here. I can feel it.
You say so.
What's wrong with them?
Get behind me. Get back to the house. Go, now! Is it bad?
What? Compared to the other guy? Thank you for saving me.
That's what a good husband does. Am I? Still?
We don't even know each other.
We're gonna get out of here. I promise.
Don't make promises you can't keep. I mean, even if we could just leave through the jungle, that thing tried to stop us. What if there's more of them? What if they're here to keep us for some reason? What if you're still lying to me just to keep me here?
I'm not. All right, I'm just as lost here as you are. You need to trust me.
Yeah? Or what?
Or we're never gonna get out of here. Look, whatever this thing is, it's pretty clear to me that we need to figure this out together. But
what?
I don't want that to be fake. You know, we may not have what we thought we had, but I want to know you. For real.
For real?
Yeah. But this isn't over. Let's go.
Of siblings. Four brothers, two sisters.
Older or younger?
I'm second oldest.
Do you get along with them?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, we have our moments, but all families do. What about you? Your turn to share.
When I think about my family, things get blurry. I have my grandparents. I remember them. I just can't seem to remember my actual parents. If I had any.
Oh. Any pets?
Nothing comes to mind.
Well, what does come to mind?
Coffee shop.
Coffee shop?
Yeah. It's a place I remember going to a lot. It was a nice one. These big windows, it was well lit. People were nice. I'd go and get something simple like a latte. And there's always a table in the corner that I'd go to sit at. But on the way there, something would catch my eye. I don't know what it is, I don't see it. But I'd set down my coffee. I go to investigate, and I don't come back for it. It gets cold.
And that's it?
That's it. It's counting up now.
Look, the caretaker said something.
He was crazy.
Yeah, well, who's to say that we're not crazy too? He said, this isn't a test that we can pass. Something like that, I don't know.
So what happens when that clock stops counting?
What?
He said none of the others ever made it this far.
No. Elle, you don't have to
do
this.
I don't want you to sacrifice yourself for me. Don't be selfish. Let me think that I can save you. Please, I'm supposed to do this.
You don't have to.
Yes, I do. Robbie, I'm
set simulation.
No! No, wake up!